When we are turning a wheel, from experience, we would normally push with one hand and pull with the other. Let's analyze these two forces. Assume the two forces are of the same magnitude and opposite direction. Therefore, they can be known as F and a negative F. And they each has a perpendicular distance of half a d from the center of the wheel, point O. We can write the force equilibrium equation that the resultant force acting on this wheel equals to F plus negative F, which is 0, which means that the forces cancel each other out, therefore have no translational effect on the wheel. These two forces are known as a couple. However, we can also calculate the total moment caused by these two forces about the center of the wheel. Since both forces are causing counterclockwise rotational effect about point O, therefore, they both create positive moments about point O, and the total moment is positive F times D, with D being the perpendicular distance between the lines of action of these two forces. In fact, we can also try to summarize the total moment caused by these two same forces about another arbitrary point, point A, that is at a distance d prime from force F, as shown. Now, this force is creating counterclockwise rotational effect about point A with a moment arm of d plus d prime, while this force is creating a clockwise rotational effect about point A with a moment arm of d prime. Therefore, the total moment can be calculated to be F times D plus D prime minus F times D prime, which is still F times D, the same as the moment we calculated earlier about point O. Even if we want to summarize the total moment caused by these two forces about a point, say point B, that is not even in the current XY plane, we can use the vector formulation to get that the total moment equals to position vector R1 cross F plus position vector R2 cross negative F equals to position vector R1 minus R2 cross F. And after applying vector calculation, this still equals to a moment with a magnitude of F times D pointing to the positive z direction, and this is still the same moment calculated about point O and point A earlier. Therefore, based on the previous three calculations, we learned that the moment of a couple is a free vector because it does not depend on the reference point, unlike the moment of a force, which is calculated differently depending on what point or axis you choose to calculate this moment about. The net external effect of a couple is that there's no net force but only a net moment. The magnitude is calculated as F times D, D being the perpendicular distance between the couple. The moment of a couple is also a vector, just like the other moment or force vectors. Therefore, the calculation still follows the rules of vector calculation. In summary, to calculate the moment of a couple, in scalar formulation, the moment equals to F times D. F is the magnitude of one force, and D is the perpendicular distance between the two forces. You need to determine if the moment is positive or negative based on if the rotational effect is counterclockwise or clockwise. In vector formulation, the moment equals to R cross F. F is one of the force vectors, and R must be the position vector that ends on this force vector. As long as R is the position vector that ends on the force vector in your calculation, it can be any position vector that's between these two force vectors. Let's look at this example. There's a pair of forces applied on this member. The two forces both have the magnitude of 5 kilonewton. They are of opposite direction, therefore they form a couple moment, and we need to determine the magnitude of this couple moment. There are many ways to solve this problem. We can always use the vector formulation. To do that, we need to first set up our coordinate system and then represent one of these two force vectors in its Cartesian vector form. In this case, I am choosing force F1. And then I need to draw a position vector that starts anywhere along the other force vector and ends anywhere along this chosen force vector F1. I have unlimited options, but this is probably the most convenient way to draw this position vector R. And I need to also represent it in its Cartesian vector form. And now I'm ready to apply the equation that the moment vector equals to the cross product of the position vector and the force vector. And the couple moment calculated is 12.5 k kilonewton meter. This unit vector k indicates that the direction of this moment is along the positive k direction, which is perpendicular to the xy plane pointing outwards. And the magnitude of the coupled moment is simply 12.5 kilonewton meter. It is positive, and that indicates that the rotational effect is counterclockwise within our xy plane. And that's the answer to this problem. But since this is a 2D problem, it is easier to apply the scalar formulation instead. For that, we need to first know the magnitude of one of these two forces, which is 5 kilonewton, and we also need to know the perpendicular distance between these two parallel forces. In this case, we can easily determine this distance from geometry to be 2.5 meter. And then the coupled moment is simply F times D to be 12.5 kilonewton meter, but when we apply scalar formulation, we need to manually determine the direction of the rotational effect. In this case, the rotational effect is counterclockwise, therefore the moment is positive. In some situations, it is easier to apply the principle of moments instead to calculate the coupled moment. To do that, we need to first resolve the forces into their respective horizontal and vertical components. As you can see, now we have two pairs of forces forming two coupled moments shown in different colors. The advantage of applying principle of moments is that now the moment arms are easy to determine. So we simply need to calculate the two coupled moments respectively and then add them together, and we will get to the same answer.